fast is the focus with these training and racing shoes that are designed to meet the needs of every runner. From world-class marathoners to those who just want to log I feel amazing miles on the weekends, with snappy full-length Nike Zoom Air or ultra-responsive Nike Zoom X Foam underfoot, each shoe in the Zoom 5 family offers a distinct experience. Just recently, Nike has officially unveiled the next shoes in their Zoom series, which includes the Nike Zoom X Vaporfly Next Percent. This shoe was debuted at the London Marathon just a few weeks ago. As you might have seen, Eliud Kipchoge won the race while wearing these shoes. Other elite athletes were wearing these shoes as well, and they looked phenomenal. So everybody's been wondering, when are these shoes going to be available to purchase? When can I get my hands on these shoes, or when can I get these shoes on my feet? They want to run races in these shoes. They want to get PRs. They want to qualify for Boston. They want to qualify for Chicago and New York without having the lottery. So with the recent announcement, they're letting the public know what the Zoom series is going to be including, and also the dates when it's going to be available. Let's see what's going on. The 2019 Nike Zoom family launches in a flooded spectrum of neon green in its most visible color to the human eye. Designers created a Nike-only version of the neon hue called Nike Phantom Glow because of its chemical makeup generates an energetic glowing effect for the Nike Zoom X Vaporfly Next Percent. The rest of the shoes are dressed in a spectrum of soft to bold hues, assuring each will stand out on the road. With these four shoes, what type of shoes will be available and which ones will be right for you? Well, it all kind of depends on what type of running or racing you plan to be doing, but surely each of these shoes will offer a different experience. So let's kind of take a brief review of what these shoes are, and you'll be able to see for yourself. Alright, starting off with the Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 36. So Nike's all-time best-selling shoe is back with a big upper refresh. Engineered mesh with added perforations enhances breathability across high heat areas such as the forefoot and arch. Exposed flywire cables in the midfoot keep you secure as you pick up speed. The heel collar and tongue are slimmer, which means a more comfortable and conforming fit than before. The Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 36 maintains its full-length Zoom Air unit, introduced in the Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 35. Encased by cushion foam in the midsole for a smooth, responsive cushion ride you can rely on day after day. Now, I'm really excited about that. I've been running in the 34 and 35 Pegasus for the last 10 months, and it's a great shoe, so I'm actually really looking forward to the updates that are coming in the 36 model. So, really exciting. And I love the color. All right, next is going to be the Nike Zoom Pegasus Turbo 2. In a second edition, the everyday trainer version of the Nike Zoom Vaporfly 4% is updated with a lighter, sleeker upper, thanks mostly to a translucent material and lofted mesh. A midfoot band locks the foot on the footbed at high speeds. Now this one I am really looking forward to. The Nike Zoom Fly 3. For the first time, the women's Nike Zoom Fly 3 houses a slightly softer sock liner with a higher arch. Both versions of the Nike Zoom Fly update feature a transparent, lighter upper with a new arch band lacing system that offers a more adjustable fit. The soft and springy Nike React midsole provides a highly responsive cushioning and houses a full-length carbon fiber plate that delivers a propulsive sensation. The shoe offset is designed to minimize Achilles strain, and the stack height offers an impact protection mile after mile. The result, confirmed by a lab test, is one of the fastest, most efficient shoes Nike makes. Pretty big claim, especially with shoes like the 4% and the Next Percent. The Zoom Fly is still going to be a highly reliable shoe for running really fast times from either 5K, 10K, half marathon, or marathon. Now, I have ran probably four half marathons in the last 10 months running in the Nike Zoom Fly. I love the shoe. I have been going to it for pretty much all my races since last September, so it is a shoe I'm really looking forward to run in my next few races. And now the one that everyone's kind of been waiting for, the Nike Zoom X Vaporfly Next Percent. Now the thing is, this shoe is not entirely brand new. There are several runners that have been using this shoe for the last set of races. You can go on YouTube and see that a lot of runners have been able to experience this shoe, run a few races, or just do a few training runs, and they all so far from what I've read and seen, not just on YouTube or just social media, but just different articles as well, that people love this shoe. They said that the, I won't really get into that. You can go on their YouTube channels and kind of see what they have to say about it, but it's so far a shoe that everyone really, really loves. So, elite athletes' feedback play a huge role in revamping the already incredibly successful system that increases running economy. Plus, a new material construction called Vaporweave on the upper is lighter than Nike Flyknit, breathable, and critically, absorbs less water from sweat or rain, so it stays airy and dry over the course of the marathon. Now that's really huge, and I think that a lot of that feedback came back from the last Boston Marathon where the conditions were not great. Designers added 15% more Nike Zoom X foam, capable of providing up to 85% energy return to the Nike Zoom X Vaporfly Next Percent. But the shoe's weight stays the same as the previous version. They've also shaved off 3mm from the offset, which is now 8mm, so you can expect to experience better stability and increased energy conservation before toe-off. Still embedded within the foam is a full-length curved carbon fiber plate that increases stiffness to provide a sensation of propulsion. A new traction pattern improves 4-foot grip so the shoe handles better in wet weather. Also on the outsole are the new contour treads with deep grooves that facilitate smoother movements during turns. Those are the four shoes. As I mentioned before, they look great. I am really excited for these. So the prices have not been yet unveiled for them, so that might happen in an announcement later on. That might happen on the date that they are released. So what is the date these shoes are going to be available for everybody? That, my friends, is going to be July 11th, where these are going to be made available globally on Nike.com, as well as probably other outlets that sell Nike shoes. But officially they will, but definitely they will be available on Nike.com, so mark your calendars. I'm guessing these shoes are not gonna last very long when they are first released. So if you are looking forward to get these shoes for your summer training or for your next race, either coming late summer or fall or winter, you want to make sure that you are ready to purchase these shoes as soon as they are available. Now, I also read that there are a few select Nike Plus members that are available to make the purchase of the shoes right away. So that is it, those are the shoes. So what do you guys think? Are you excited about these shoes? Are you excited about the colors? Are you excited about the type of features that these are gonna have? Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think, what you guys are looking to do. If you like Nike, if you don't like him so much. So thank you very much for joining me this evening. Subscribe if you haven't already. I hope you guys have a great training run this week. I hope your long runs or races this weekend are gonna be awesome. And as always, I'll see you guys at the starting line. We'll see you later. Take care.